Hello, everyone. My name is Carl Urban. I am going to be your moderator today. I work for WRMA. Today is the first of a series of events that we are working with ACL on to support your work as new ACL grantees, the goal being to help you to achieve successful grants. These events are going to include a meeting this spring, which you've heard about, and which we will talk a little bit more about at the end of this webinar. We'll probably have a meeting at the NAPSA conference this summer and some additional webinars. We'll talk a little bit more at the end of this meeting about the spring meeting. Today's topic is using available resources to ensure successful grants. Before we get started, I would like all of our presenters today to introduce themselves. And we will start with ACL staff.
Okay, hi everyone, this is Hillary Dallin. I'm not exactly a presenter, but I am the director of the Office of Elder Justice and Adult Protective Services, and just very proud to work with an amazing team who are among the presenters. I'm gonna let them introduce themselves, but I just wanna say welcome to what will, as Carl said, be a series of webinars. We look forward to seeing you in person very soon. We really, I believe, with this set of grants, have strengthened our technical assistance and our relationships with you, both on the phone and in person and in every which way, so we're very excited about that. I want to emphasize to you that we have our own version of a no wrong door policy, which is to say, any question that you have, be it substantive, procedural, anything else that you want to know more about, questions, concerns, ideas, thoughts, whatever it may be, please come to your project officer, and they will get you to the right resource and to the answers to everything. And I know they will, that they're amazing people, our project officers who are presenters who are about to introduce themselves. And finally, thank you APS TARC for facilitating this webinar, for helping to organize our technical assistance to you grantees, and for all of the other invaluable work that you do, APS TARC. So thank you, thank you, thank you. And with that, I think I turn it over to Stephanie.
Stephanie, you want to introduce yourself?
That's an introduction.
Thank you. I'm Stephanie Whittier-Eliason. I am the Elder Rights Team Lead in our Office of Elder Justice and Adult Protective Services. I actually don't have any of you as a grantee, but I was a project officer and I still am and sometimes, but I'm here to support you all.
I think we lost an audio feed, Stephanie. Yeah, I lost it too, and I am here, but I don't hear the ACL staff.
Yeah, Stephanie, if you're still talking, we lost. There you are.
Hi, so sorry. I think where did we leave off?
Our phone keeps.
Stephanie, do we lose them again?
No, we're here. We're
Woo-hoo!
Here.
Okay, so Stephanie Whittier-Eliason, Elder Rights Team Lead, Office of Elder Justice, APS, and I'll just move on to Aisha.
Hi, Aisha. Greetings, everyone. Aisha Gurley Perry here at ACL. I've been a project officer with you guys since 2015, and we welcome you again. Elizabeth?
And this is Elizabeth Petrui. I am the newest addition to the Office of Elder Justice and Adult Protective Services, but I have had the pleasure of speaking with several of you grantees already, and with some who I have not been assigned to, and it is a pleasure every day to learn about your projects and to help you in any way I can.
And the other voice you heard was Andy Capehart. Andy?
Hi, I'm Amy Capehart. I am with the APS TARC. I'm employed with WRMA, the contractor for this, and I'm in charge of the programmatic technical assistance. I'll be telling you a little bit more in a bit what that means exactly. Glad to be with you today.
So as we get started today, a couple of the proverbial housekeeping rules. If you've got a question or a comment, right now you are muted, so you will need to use the raise your hand feature on your GoToWebinar panel, as you can see here. And Andy will unmute you so you can ask your question. Another option is to type a question in the question and answer box. We do have time set aside at the end for questions as well. And I think we're pretty open to answering questions as we go, or saving all the questions to the end. We'll just see how it goes. A couple of other things to note. One, we are recording this webinar, and we will be sending out the link to it for those that may have missed it, or if you want to go back and listen to something in it. We will also be sending out the slides after the meeting as well. So today we want to cover a few things that are all kind of centered around helping you get started with your grant. These things are pretty high level. Some of this stuff some of you may already know, but it never hurts to hear it again. And so the things we want to focus on is the importance of building relationships within your agencies. Particularly, we're going to talk about your fiscal office and your contracts office. Also, another critical relationship is with the Federal Office of Grants Management, and we'll go through some of how you need to make that work. We're going to try to give you the big picture of the life cycle of the grant, talk about some of the key deadlines along the way. Andy and I are with the APS TARC, and we're going to talk about our role, our resources to assist you, and kind of what the protocols are for accessing that resource. And then, as I indicated earlier, we're going to give you a little heads up on the spring meeting for grantees and tell you a little bit more about that, what you need to be doing now, and what you need to do to prepare for that. And with that, I am going to turn it over to Stephanie.
Hi, everyone. Thanks very much, Carl. So I get to talk to you all about building key agency relationships. And this is something that we've experienced a lot with our past grantees. And it just really, you know, came to our attention that I know it sounds obvious when we talk about it, but oftentimes we overlook the need to make these connections until we actually need something from these people. And then we're trying to both get to know them and say, hey, and by the way, I need something from you at the same time. And that doesn't always create the best amicable working relationship. So we wanted to really draw your attention to the fact that there are a few key relationships that you all should think about building now at the beginning of your grant, because you will need things from them. So it's better to have that relationship ahead of time. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is figure out who in your office or in your agency, whether that is specifically for your APS office or if you're under a larger administrative umbrella, who is your fiscal office contact? Because you're going to need some things from them, and you need to hear from them how much sort of advance notice that they would like you to give them. So for instance, if you were going to do a carryover request from year one to year two of funds that you didn't spend, or you have a no-cost extension, you're going to need to know how much money you're actually going to be carrying over. How much money have you pulled down? How much money have you submitted, for instance, invoices that haven't yet posted, that your fiscal office hasn't posted? So you should meet your fiscal person, whoever's going to be managing that part of the grant for you. and have these questions or have these conversations with them. How much time do you need to produce my 425? You know, how often do you pay the invoices, or you know, when do you draw down funds on my grant? Each office, each state does it differently. And depending on how they do it is going to make a difference on what information you need to get them and when you need to get it to them so that you can meet your federal grant requirements related to fiscal issues. So take a walk, take some coffee, take a donut, and, you know, get to know who they are. And especially related to, hold on a second, it doesn't like my thumbprint, so that must be yours. And then also this payment management system. This is the system that is actually, it's actually going to manage your payments if you look at it that way. And so that's something your fiscal person's going to need to know about. They may want you to do some things and want you to look at it. It just depends. So please, one of the first things that you should be doing in these first few months is really getting to know that person, especially because you'll have some reports that are due at the end of your first grant year. So let's find out, you know, how often do they, you know, check the payment management system, et cetera. So you know how much time you need to get those documents ready. So that's what I have on that one. Next slide, please. I was looking at Elizabeth to do that, but she can't. Okay, so the next thing that you might want to do is figure out who in your state agency you're going to be working with related to any contracts. A lot of you will be either hiring a consultant or you might be working with another organization to do something for you. It could be technology, any number of things. It could be evaluation, anything. But you need to understand your acquisitions process. So how long does it take to actually go through a procurement? How long do the steps take? How many layers of, you know, review and approval are required? How do I announce that I have funds available? To whom can I provide a subcontract or bring someone on as a consultant? What are those different mechanisms and how do I pay them? You need to find out what your contracting office needs from you during the life of your subcontract. So your relationship with ACL is a grant from us to you. And so you're going to have that kind of fiscal relationship as well as your project office or programmatic relationship. Then you're going to have another relationship between you and whomever your sub is. And your acquisitions office or your contracting office is going to, you need to work with them and understanding what they need from you, what is that process like. And you would be surprised at how long it takes things. Even us, we're surprised. You know, if we wanted to have a new contract out by the end of this fiscal year, we are already late and it's January. So it's just amazing. So it's very important, and you don't know if you're going to need this now. Maybe you'll need it later, but it's always good just to go by and get to know these people. So that's what we want to say about contract management. So go on to the next slide, please. All right. So I'm going to turn this over to our lovely colleague, Aisha Perry, who's going to talk about working with the Federal Office of Grants Management.
Hi. Greetings again, everyone. So as you know, our Office of Grants Management has several responsibilities. And so there's some of their responsibilities are fiscal oversight. And what that means, they oversee the monitoring of the monetary actions of your grant that you submit within Grant Solutions. So if you have any monetary actions, as Stephanie stated, carryovers, no-cost extensions, transfers, et cetera, please make sure you submit those requests in Grant Solutions. And if you have any issues with submitting them, reach out to your project officer, or you can always reach out to the grants management specialist that's assigned to your grant. As it relates to compliance with the grant, the GMO or the grants management specialist and the project officer do a team monitoring of your grant. So we make sure that your grant is adhering to ACLs and HHS policies. So we won't fall out of compliance and we won't get dinged. And so we can continue to award you guys funds to do some great things out in the state. Hi, so this is a great question or a great bullet that we have here.
Go back, Carl.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Wait, is this great one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this great bullet right here that we have on your screen, I know some of you guys have experienced this and some hiccups or even some barriers as it relates to submitting carryovers, no cost extensions, revisions in your amendments or revisions in your work plan. So when you guys are doing those, please work in conjunction with your project officer so you can make sure that you're submitting the right documentation so we won't have any delays. I know we've experienced quite a few delays with some of you guys submitting some of these requests, and we don't want to encounter that again. So we're going to try to work hand in hand with you guys as well as our grants management office to ensure that they are submitted correctly, timely, and accurately. And again, if you always have questions, please send an email to your project officer and copy Sean Lewis, whose name is also mentioned on the PowerPoint, as well as you can always visit our acl.gov website to explain more about what it looks like to submit amendment through Grant Solutions or to your project officer. And I'll turn it over to Elizabeth.
All right. Thank you, Aisha, and thank you for switching the slides, Carl. So just to go back, zoom out a little bit, look at the big picture, we're still in the first 6 months of this grant, but it's a three-year project, potentially longer if no-cost extensions have to be applied for. And so we just wanted to go over sort of the life cycle of the grant. Coming up in March, you will be submitting your first progress report. These are, or April 1st, Aisha is reminding me. So that'll cover all of the activity that you've done from September 1st through the end of February, and then you'll have until April 1st to submit that in Grant Solutions as a note. Your project officer will review it, reach out to you if they have any questions, and then we'll submit our own documentation saying we've reviewed it, everything looks good, carry on. So we have done our monitoring and that's recorded in Grant Solutions. Now, at the end of your first project year, you'll be submitting your first financial status report, which is also known as the SF-425. That's something that, like Stephanie was mentioning earlier, you'll work with your fiscal contact to put together and to make sure everything is recorded, and that'll be due November 1st, end of October, November 1st to cover that first year. Carryover requests. So at the end of any budget period, so at the end of the first year, the second year, if something has happened, there's been a delay, say in hiring, this is a common example, you're not able to hire, let's say, your training educator to come in and do some training that you had allocated for until 6 months into the grant. You allocated, you know, funds for their salary and fringe benefits for those first 6 months, but you didn't spend it because you weren't able to hire them until midway through the project. You are going to carry over those funds from year one to year two to make sure that the items in the work plan are still being completed, and you'll write a letter justifying why they weren't completed because of delays in the hiring process in order for that to be approved. And so if that's a situation, you should be in communication with your project officer about any delays, but we will be happy to help you if you think that that is something that you are going to need to do. In terms of no-cost extensions, so at the end of before the end of the entire project period, so, you know, in about 2 years, so 3 to 6 months before the end of the three-year project, we're going to take a look at that approved work plan and say, what's left to be done? Is it feasible that it's all going to be completed within the 3 years? If for whatever reason it's not, let's say it took you 6 months or more to hire, or there were delays with your state government allowing you to access funds, if there was a hiring freeze, there's any number of reasons why those project activities would not have been completed. And in that case, you're going to need to apply for a no-cost extension. no-cost extensions must be applied for at least 30 days prior to the expiration of the grant. If the grant, we get to the end of, you know, August 31st, 2021, and nothing has been submitted, your grant is going to be expired. And our Office of Grants Management has stated that they are not going to be willing to work with us once that grant is expired. So we need to really be proactive and make sure we're submitting things early. And then at the end of the grant, so either in 3 years or if there's a no-cost extension, more than 3 years, once you've completed all of the activities in your work plan, you'll have 90 days from the end of the project period to submit your final narrative report. That's going to cover the entire life of the grant, all of the activities that you did in the project period, including the last 6 months. So it's cumulative of the whole project. You'll have been submitting progress reports every 6 months up until that point, but you don't have to do a progress report for the last 6 months. That will be included in the final report. So we don't want to make extra work for you there. And that is the high level 30,000 foot view of the life of your grant.
And this is Stephanie, everyone. Don't panic. We will, you know, be working with you all throughout the process, reminding you of these timelines and everything.
Great. Thank you, Elizabeth. This is Andy Capehart again. I'm going to take just a minute to talk a little bit about the APS Technical Assistance Resource Center, or the APS TARC, as we call it. The APS TARC serves as a resource to all of the APS programs across the whole U.S., but we prioritize requests that come from ACL grantees. So our role is to help you in any way that we can with your project content. If you would like some help with achieving the objectives in your project, we are the folks to turn to. So for instance, we fielded questions about quality assurance from other grantees because some states were focusing on quality assurance efforts, so we were able to provide them some technical assistance on that particular area. So we're the ones you should call for expertise with any programmatic issues. We have several subject matter experts on staff who have a wide variety of experience, and we also work closely with the National Adult Protective Services Association, who is a wealth of knowledge. You can reach out to us via your ACL program officer, through your neighbor's liaison, or any TARC staff, or you can use the contact us form available at the website, at the web address that's noted on your screen there towards the bottom. Once we receive your request, we'll contact you to get more information and sort out what the best way is that we can help you, and we'll get back to you quickly about that. Next slide, Carl. So just a few other thoughts about how the TARC can assist you. You may want to consider joining our APS listserv. If you're not already familiar with listservs, they're an email form for reaching out to us and to other colleagues in the field across the United States. The listserv is a great option to learn from your peers about how they were handling issues in their own states and to get ideas and suggestions from other folks. If you're interested in joining listserv, reach out to us anytime for more information. We will gladly send you some more information about it. You may also want to consider following us on social media for information on what is happening in the world of APS.
Andy, where did you go? Andy,
I'm not
are you there?
I'm not glad we lost Andy, but I am a little bit glad we're not the only ones having phone problems.
Elizabeth, I assume you can hear me?
Yes, sir.
All right, so I will finish up what Andy was saying. So you can follow us on social media and you see the three places that you can contact us there. And so we want to now transition to talking a little bit about our spring meeting. And so we want to kind of give you a heads up on some aspects of our meeting that we're going to be having. Most of this information you are aware of from previous email communication that we sent you. The meeting is going to be held at the Crown Plaza National Airport, which, as the name implies, is located very close to Reagan National Airport. The idea is that we will all travel in on Monday, start bright and early on Tuesday morning, and finish early on Wednesday afternoon. We've outlined a number of topics that we're going to be covering, such as talking about outcomes, talking about how to engage stakeholders, sustainability, along with a few other things, all of which are kind of geared towards helping you achieve successful grants. The way we're going to approach this is that we're going to have a lot of good content from our key faculty that we have lined up, but just as important, we're going to have a, we hope to have an environment where we are learning from each other, getting to know each other better, and then through these workshops, trying to walk out with some action steps that you can take to implement your grant successfully. We're going to be communicating some more detail about this to you in the near future. And we do think that we're going to ask you to do a little work beforehand to help us prepare for the meeting and to help you prepare for the meeting. I promise you it's going to be pretty simple and pretty quick, but it will go a long ways towards helping us to have a successful meeting. As I mentioned, you should have an email with the meeting logistics already, including how to reserve rooms. I would point out that the registration deadline for the spring meeting hotel reservation online is February the 25th. And so our agenda for the workshop looks like this: welcome and overview, sharing and connecting, where we're going to learn about each other's grants and learn about how we can help support one another through this process. And then we're going to talk about the topics of outcomes, culture change, engaging stakeholders, making your project sustainable. And then the last thing will be using some practical stuff about using grant solutions and other grants management tips. And so you can see how all of these are supported and supporting you in trying to achieve a successful grant. And with that, that takes care of all of the content that we have prepared. And so we would like to answer any questions. The first one of which is Andy with us or not? Andy, are you back?
I am. I'm so sorry. I have no idea what happened. Oh, the joys of technology. It completely dropped. But it sounds like, Carl, you picked up and carried the social media torch for me. So I appreciate that. So yeah,
I'm so good at social media. Andy, do you have any questions so far?
I am back on. We did have one question about whether the slides would be sent out after the call. We can certainly send the slides to you after this call so that you have copies of that, along with a link to the recording of today's webinar. So that will be provided to all of you who are attending. We don't have any other questions, I don't believe, right now, or any hands raised. So if you have questions about anything we talked about from any of our presenters, now is a good time to ask those questions. You can type them in the question box. I will read them aloud for our presenters. Or if you want to raise your hand, we will unmute your line just so that you know. There's some people who are listening through their computer may not have a microphone on your computer, so you might want to type if you know that you don't have a microphone and you're listening on your computer. So you might want to type your question in. And there was one question about, was something sent out about registering ahead of time for the spring meeting? I don't believe we've sent anything about registering for the meeting itself. We simply sent out a link to make your room reservation. So if you have not received that, we need to make sure that you get that. And then I can, I have track of the person who asked that question, so I'll follow up with you after the webinar to see that if you got that. So one question is go ahead, Carl.
No, go ahead, Andy.
One question for our ACL folks is there a format for the 6-month report?
I'll go ahead.
Yes,
there is. The end. No, just kidding.
I got an answer.
I know. I thought that was funny. So we have a format, and we have some suggested guidance for you all as well. So, Andy, if you go back to the slide that had the ACL website that had managing your grants,
one more forward.
Aisha says six. Go ahead. Keep going. Right there. So if you go to that link to guidance on managing your grant, There is a download that is available that is for reports. That one document has the template for both your six-month report and your final report. So you can always find it there and download it and work in it. Now, we have some guidance that we've created that we give our grantees that that helps sort of helps you think about the answering the questions on the form in a way that makes sense for these projects, because the form is a general form that's approved by the Office of Management and Budget, and all of our grants, most of our grants use it. So it's not really tailored to what, you know, any particular grant program. So the guidance that we'll share with you after this is really just how do you answer those few questions that are on the six-month report template in a way that makes a lot of sense for meeting the objectives of this program, of your state enhancement grant. And we'll share that after the call. So good question.
Thank you, Stephanie. There is another question. Are you going to be setting future meetings with your team throughout the year? And I believe that may be in regards to some of the meetings we talked about earlier, some of the webinars that we have, and yes, we'll be sending out those meetings as those are scheduled, I believe, is the plan. Can you correct me if I'm wrong about that?
So we have, we schedule meetings with our grantees, and they're based on a scale in which we rate them. And so if their grantee falls within the red, yellow, or green category, determines how frequent the grant, the project officer meets with the particular grantee. I'm not sure if that's the question that they're asking, Andy.
Yeah, I'm not sure too. So if that person who asked that question could clarify a little bit. If you're referring to meetings such as this or webinars such as this, yes, we will be having more throughout the year, and we'll be sending those out and plenty of ahead of time, several weeks in advance, for you to register for those. And the person said, yeah, webinars such as this, yes, there will be others, and we will be sending those out several weeks in advance so that you can register for those. Yes. I am not seeing any other questions just yet. So as a reminder, if you have questions about anything we talked about today, type them in the question box, or you can raise your hand and we will unmute your line and give that a shot. If you have a microphone, if you're on the telephone listening.
So, not seeing or hearing any additional questions, we want to thank y'all for participating in our first webinar. We look forward to seeing you in March in Washington, and we will be sending you out some information, more information regarding that meeting. And as the last question asked, we'll be sending out some additional information for the communication and the support throughout the rest of the year as well. And with that, I will just check in with ACL to see if you have any more comments. And after that, we will be adjourned.
I don't think we have anything else to add other than if the participants, anybody on the line, has any additional feedback of what they would like from future webinars or calls, we would be happy to receive that. WRMA and the APS TARC have a great plan, and they have a lot of topics in mind. But if there's something that is burning on your heart that you would like us to address, we would love to hear it.
And
There's a brief survey, actually, to that remark. There's a brief survey that will pop up on your screen after this, and we'll be sending an email after the webinar is over with, and you will have an opportunity to provide us some feedback there as well.
Great. That is great. And with that, I think, yes, we are done. Thank you all.
Great. Thank you, guys. All right.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.